I'm trying to write a song about Santa Claus, man, but it's not coming
about
out.
About who, man?
About Santa Claus, man. You know, Santa Claus,
oh,
man.
Oh, yeah, man. I played with those dudes, man.
What?
Yeah, last year at the Fillmore, man. Me and the bass player sat in, man.
Oh, hey, man, you think Santa Claus is a groove, huh? No, it's not a groove, man.
Would they break up, man?
Oh, no, man, it's one guy, man. You know, he had a red suit on, man, with black patent leather shoes. You know the guy, man?
Oh, yeah. He's with Motown, ain't he?
No, man.
Yeah. Hi beautiful people, I'm back, but clearly I'm back with another reaction video, and in this episode I'm going to be watching Cheech and Chong on Santa Claus and his old lady, and I'm super excited. You know, Christmas is around the corner, right? I don't know, in your area have you started hearing the jingle bells? Let me know in the comment section, and so I can't wait to see what this has in store for us, and I'm hoping that you're going to take this journey with me all the way to the end of this video. And as per usual, I'll be giving my comments at the end of it. So I hope to see you there. And if this is the kind of content you're interested in, look no further, because you're right in the right place. So go ahead right now and do that thing, smash on that red subscribe button down below if you haven't done so already, and join me, and together let's enjoy this and many more videos to come. So before I begin, I'd love to give a shout out to Mark for sponsoring this video. So Mark, thank you so much, and without further ado, let's see what Cheech and Chong has to say about Santa Claus and his old lady, and see you at the end.
Mama, mamacita, donde está Santa Claus? The vato with a bone in knees, he's coming down the street with no shoes on his feet, and he's going to... No, that ain't it. Mama, mamacita, donde está Santa Claus? The guy with the hair on his jaws, he... Hey, man, come over here, man. I need some help, man.
Yeah, man, I can dig that. Like, what are you doing, man?
I'm trying to write a song about Santa Claus, man, but it's not coming
about
out.
About who, man?
About Santa Claus, man. You know, Santa Claus,
oh,
man.
Oh, yeah, man. I played with those dudes, man.
What?
Yeah, last year at the Fillmore, man. Me and the bass player sat in, man.
Oh, hey, man, you think Santa Claus is a groove, huh? No, it's not a groove, man.
Would they break up, man?
Oh, no, man, it's one guy, man. You know, he had a red suit on, man, with black patent leather shoes. You know the guy, man?
Oh, yeah. He's with Motown, ain't he?
No, man.
Yeah, I played with that dude, too. Man. No, yeah, he's a good singer, man.
No, hold on, man. He's not with Motown, man.
I have no idea.
Well, then he's with Buddha, man.
No. Oh, man, you don't know who Santa Claus is, man.
Yeah, well, I'm not from here, man. Like, I'm from Pittsburgh, man. I don't know too many local dudes.
Oh, I see. Well, hey, man, sit back and relax, and I'll tell you the story about Santa Claus, man.
Wait a minute, guys. Like, who doesn't know Santa Claus? This is just so funny. I'm loving it a lot. And I love how he's so, like, he doesn't know a thing and he's trying to guess and it's just all fun. So anyway, I hope you're loving it because I sure am. And let's continue watching. I'll take it slightly back as always. Then we recap and continue.
Know too many local dudes.
Oh, I see. Well, hey, man, sit back and relax and I'll tell you the story about Santa Claus, man. Listen. Once upon a time, about 5 years ago, there was this groovy dude, and his name was Santa Claus, you know? And he used to live over in the projects with his old lady. And they had a pretty good thing together because his old lady was really fine, and she could cook and all that stuff like that. You know, like, she made the best brownies in town, man. Oh, I could remember them now, man. I could eat one of them, man.
Wow, did you know these people, man?
Oh, yeah, man. They used to live next door to me, you know, until they got kicked out, man.
What, they got kicked out of the projects, man?
Yeah, you know what happened, man? They used to live with all these midgets, you know? And the midgets used to make a lot of noise, you know, like pounding and hammering and pounding all night, man.
Typical freaks.
Oh, man. Yeah, man, they were really freaks, man. As a matter of fact, they all moved up north together, you know?
Well, they have to go get their head together, man.
Yeah, get their head together, man. And they started a commune, you know? It was called the Santa Claus and His Old Lady commune. It was a real famous one up there, man. And they used to sit around and groove all the time, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Really good time, man.
Hey, that sounds heavy.
Yeah, eat the brownies, man. They drink the tea, man. And what they did most of the time, though, was make a lot of goodies, you know?
Oh, yeah.
And they had everything they needed. They only needed to come into town maybe once a year or something like that.
Pick up the welfare check and the food stamp.
Yeah, man. No, what they did, man, is once a year when they made all the goodies, you know, they used to put them in a big chopping bag, and then they used to take the chopping bag and deliver them to all the boys and girls all the way around the world,
hey,
man.
Hey, well, that's it, man. Yeah, that sounds real nice.
Oh, yeah, they were really nice people, man. And so much class, man. They had so much class, you know. Like even take the way they used to deliver the toys, you know. It's like Santa Claus used to have this really sharp short, man, you know. It was lowered to the ground at twice pipes, candy apple red, and button tuck. Ooh, clean.
Man, that sounds like a hip snowmobile, man.
No, it wasn't a snowmobile. It was a sled, you know. One of those big sleds, you know. And he used to have it pulled by some reindeers, you know, like reindeers.
Some what, man?
Some reindeers, you know. He used to hook them onto the sled, and then he used to stand up inside the sled and hold onto the reins, and then call out their names, like, on Donner, on Blissen, on Chewy, on Tabo, come on, Bertha. And then the reindeers used to take off into the sky and fly across the sky, man.
Man, that's far out, man.
Yeah, and then when they flight across the sky, they used to come down to places like, oh, Chicago, L.A., Nueva York, and Pacoima, and all those places, you know, and then land on top of people's roofs, and then old Santa Claus would make himself real small, you know, like a real small guy, and he'd come down the chimney, and then he would give you all the stuff that he made, man, and dig this, man, he did it all in one night, man.
Hey, just a minute, man. Now, how'd he do that, man?
Oh, well, man, he took the freeway. How else, man?
No, man. How did he do all that other stuff, man? Like, how'd he make himself small, man? And how'd he get the reindeer off the ground, man?
Oh, well, man, he had some magic dust, man.
Some magic dust?
Yeah, magic dust. You know, he used to give a little bit to the reindeer, a little bit to Santa Claus, a little bit more for Santa Claus, a little bit more.
And this would get the reindeer off, man?
Oh, got 'em off, man. Are you kidding, man? They flew all the way around the world, man.
That's far out, man. Hey, how come I've never met this dude, man?
Oh, man, he doesn't do that bit anymore, man. It got too dangerous, man.
Yeah, I can dig that, man, because that's a dangerous bit, man.
Yeah, let me tell you, it sure was, man. Like, just 2 years ago, man, he got stopped at the border, you know, and they took him into another room and took off his clothes, man, and searched him and searched his bag of goodies, man. And then when he was leaving, man, he was flying through the air, somebody took a shot at his reindeer, you know?
Oh, that's a drag,
yeah,
man.
It really was, man. And then, man, he went down south, man, and they tried to cut off his hair and his beard, man. And all the time he was getting stopped and pulled over and asked for his ID, man. Just everywhere he went, he ran into too much recession, man.
No, man, you mean he ran into too much repression, man.
Repression, recession, man. It's all the same thing, man.
Yeah, man. It's a drag, man, because we could sure use a dude like that right now.
You know, oh, well, he still comes around, man.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, but he comes in disguises now.
Oh, he went underground.
Yeah,
huh?
Underground, man.
Yeah, I can dig it.
Yeah, but you want to see his disguise, man. Nobody would ever know it was him, man.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he's got a job in front of the department store, ringing this bell and playing this tambourine next to this black pot, you know?
Oh, I seen the dude.
Yeah,
man.
You know who I'm talking about,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, man. I played with that cat last year, man.
What?
Yeah, we played in front of a store, man. We made a lot of bread.
Oh, hey,
man.
Wait a minute, man. Santa Claus is not a musician, man.
I'm hip, man. That cat didn't know any tunes, man.
Oh, hey, wait a minute, man. No, he's not into that at all, man.
No, I played with this dude.
Are you sure, man?
I'm positive.
He knows nothing. He's talking about played. That's good.
Mama.
That was a very good story, and they are such good storytellers. I don't know about you, but I loved and enjoyed the story, and I love how this other guy was so naive and didn't know anything, and so it was a very interesting story. I loved listening to it, and it reminds me of the Christmas movies that I watch, and because over here we don't have Christmas the same way I see in movies, so it's kind of different. So anyway, that was good. I loved it, and I hope you did as well. So if you enjoyed this, kindly go ahead right now and give this video a thumbs up, and don't forget to leave a comment and share with me what wowed you about it, and how you felt about it. For me, it was the fact that it was a story. I love stories. You know that by now, right? So the fact that it was a story, and how this other guy was acting so naive and so clueless about Santa, and the other one explaining. So I don't know who's Cheech and who's Chong, but it was incredible. So yeah, basically that's all I can say. It was an interesting story in the best way told. So let me know in the comment section if you enjoyed it. And if you did, consider to give it a thumbs up as always. So basically that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I love you so much. And I appreciate your love and support so far. So basically before I go, I want to let you know that if you're new here, welcome and feel right at home. Don't forget to smash the red subscribe button down below so that you can officially be part of this beautiful family, and together we can enjoy such videos going forward. And if you'd love to be notified each and every time I post a video, consider to smash the notification bell as well so that you don't miss out on any episode going forward. Last but not least, if you'd love to support this channel, you're welcome to do so. All you need to do is check the description below where you'll find the link to my Patreon community as well as my PayPal address. And just like Mark, you too can have guaranteed requests through either platforms. So once again, thank you so much for watching. Asanteni sana, that is Swahili for thank you so much. And I'm looking forward to having a conversation with you in the comment section. And if you enjoyed, don't forget to thumbs up. So I'm wishing you a happy Christmas season, because today is the just first of December. So I'm wishing you a merry, merry Christmas. And we are still together. So see you in the next episode. So until then, take care of yourself. Be safe. And for now, peace out and bye.